Proponents of this school of thought, like the CEO of the European Organization for Sustainable Development, believe that there is need to rally society around saving and investing as a way of building local capital.
Domestically mobilized money is more reliable source of fund than the overseas capital. It is not prone to currency mismatches, and it is less vulnerable to international geopolitical disruptions. We have experienced firsthand during the still unfolding coronavirus crisis that countries with a strong domestic fund mobilization infrastructure are surviving the crisis far better than those who are dependent on external debts.
The two-day conference hosted by the Uganda Development Bank was convened to contemplate new ways of financing sustainable development in the post-COVID-19 era.
Not only providing capital, but also providing the tools that they themselves need to mobilize capital domestically. Let's see that move to things like crowdfunding, which is much cheaper. Let's see the move to things like equity solutions, all of which could be negotiated or developed through a bank like UDB or through our influence on the financial sector.
Another way this could work is marketplaces where such discussions could connect those in need and those with the finances. Finance Minister Matia Kasaija also believes that the financial institutions ought to take the lead in financing Ghana's development.
My clear message to the banks here is that the time for providing financial services merely to make profits, i.e., without contributing to national development, is now behind us.
Bank of Uganda, in different reports, has previously indicated that majority Ugandans live hand-to-mouth with low savings, something that could complicate implementation of the new financing model. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.